Hello students, today we are going to read about the topic from module 3, that is how to determine the method of lighting. So this is about different lighting calculations, which is otherwise called as illumination engineering also. So today we'll read about the different methods which are employed for this lighting calculation. So there are a number of methods which have been employed for these lighting calculations, but among which you may mention that there are three important methods. There are three methods by virtue of which we are going to do these lighting calculations. Okay, so these particular lighting calculations about which we are going to study. So, in brief, we are going to study these three methods. So, these three methods are: the first method is watts per square meter method. The second method is also called as light flux method or lumen method. And the third method is your point to point or inverse square law method. So, based on this also, you are expected to get some problems also. Okay. So the first method is your watt per square method. Clear? So as the name suggests, the watt per square meter method. So this actually, this method is totally based on the principle of rule of thumb method, and which is very handy for doing some kind of rough calculations or checking. Now, here in this particular method, it consists in making an allowance of watts per square meter of area to be illuminated according to the illumination desired on the assumption of an average figure of overall efficiency of the system. That means it actually gives a kind of allowance. So how much watts of power, okay, per meter square of area has to be illuminated. So according to the how much illumination you are going to decide, and here the assumption that we are going to take is average figure of overall efficiency of the system. Okay, so here method is your lumen or the light flux method. Now here this method is applicable to those cases where the sources of light are such as to produce an approximate uniform illumination. Now, in those cases, you are going to use this particular method, lumen method, or this light flux method, is where the sources of light are such as to produce an approximate uniform illumination. Suppose you want to produce a uniform illumination over the working space, or where you require a particular average value. Okay, so depending upon the size of the lamp or the size of the lamps that you are going to put, and from the efficiency, from their efficiency, lamp efficiency, so what is the total output, what is the total lumen output, that is you are going to determine. Clear? So for that, there is a particular formula. So whatever the total lumen output that you are getting from the source, that you are going to multiply by the coefficient of utilization. Okay, and that particular lumens that is received on that particular working plane is determined by that particular formula. Suppose the surrounding is the lamp, and the surroundings of that particular lamp are totally clean, perfectly clean. Then while you're determining the lumens received on working plane in case of perfectly clean surroundings, then you have to include one factor, which is also called as a depreciation factor or the maintenance factor, which should be included. Okay, so this is here. Now this is the formula. That is, lumens received on working plane is equal to number of lamps into each lamp has a particular wattage, that you have to multiply it with number of lamps, and efficiency of each lamp in terms of lumens per watt. In the units of lumens per watt, what is the efficiency? That also you have to multiply. Again, multiplied by coefficient of utilization by depreciation factor. Now, this depreciation factor will come into picture when the lamp and surroundings are not perfectly clean. Okay, so suddenly there is a mistake. If it is not perfectly clean, then this depreciation factor will come into picture. Okay, not in clean, when it is not perfectly clean. Okay, so what are the lumens that is received on working plane? So this is the formula. Then you should know what is this coefficient of utilization factor. So the coefficient of utilization or the utilization factor which is there in the formula is the whole, it is the whole light that is radiated by the lamp actually does not reach the working plane. Okay, so the ratio of this particular lumens or the light that is reaching the working plane to the total lumen given out by the lamp is known as actually the utilization factor or coefficient of utilization. That means it's a very, by a simple example, I'll say you, suppose I am giving you 100 rupees. So this 100 rupees is the total money that I am giving you. Clear? And this is an example which you can correlate it. Total money I am giving you. So out of 100 rupees, you are only utilizing 20 rupees. Okay, so the utilization factor here will be how much? So 20 by 100. So 0.2 is the utilization factor. Similarly, the total lumen that is given by the lamp. Okay, and then how much actually from that total lumen which is getting that is generated from the lamp, from that the total, how much of the lumen is reaching actually the working plane? Clear? Suppose out of 100% lumen, only 20% of lumen is only reaching that particular working plane. So that ratio 20 by 100 is called as the utilization factor. I hope you understood. So higher the value of utilization factor, more lumens is reaching the working plane. Clear? So the frankly speaking, the value of this utilization factor totally depends upon four parameters. The parameters are, first factor is the mounting height of lamp. Okay, so utilization factor is how it is depending upon the height of the lamp. So the utilization factor decreases. No doubt, when the height of the lamp is increasing, mounting height, so ultimately the utilization factor decreases. Area to be illuminated for given height. For a given height, okay, so it also depends upon the area that you are going to illuminate, the area that you are going to give the light. So for a particular height, the proportion of direct light becomes more and more if floor area is increasing. That is, what is happening is utilization factor increases with an increase in area to be illuminated. Then third is type of lighting. Okay, so which type of lighting actually you are using? The more the direct light, low will be the indirect lighting. Clear? More is the direct light, then low. More for direct light. That means utilization factor is more for direct lighting, and utilization factor is very less for indirect lighting. Then color of surroundings. That means the utilization factor will be more for light colors and utilization factor will be less for dark colors. So actually the utilization factor varies from 0.25 to 0.5 and from 0.1 to 0.25. That means for direct lighting it varies from 0.25 to 0.5 and for indirect lighting it varies from 0.1 to 0.25. So these are the four factors or the values of utilization factor. It totally depends upon this four. This is again a very important question. Upon what factors the value of utilization factor depends? Utilization factor of the lighting depends. Okay, so the mounting height, the area to be illuminated. The mounting height means if the utilization factor decreases, if there is an increase in the height, if there is a decrease in the height, the utilization factor increases. Then area to be illuminated, that means utilization factor increases with the increase in area that is to be illuminated. Then type of lighting, utilization factor increases for direct lighting, decreases for indirect lighting. Now color of surroundings is the utilization factor is more for light colors and utilization factor is very less for dark colors. So the value is varying from 0.25 to 0.5 for direct lighting scheme and from 0.1 to 0.25 for indirect lighting scheme. So next is the maintenance factor. Okay, so in this we have the other factor is which is coming into picture, which is called as the maintenance factor and the depreciation factor. Clear? So this is these factors we are using only and when the lamp surroundings are not perfectly clean. So what is maintenance factor? So the illumination produced by lighting installation is considerably less. That means whatever the the lighting that it is produced, the brightness of the light that is produced when you are installing the light, after 1 year or 2 years, the illumination is of that particular light will be considerably less than it was installed initially. That means a new light, when you are installing for the first time, it is much more brighter. After 1 or 2 years, the brightness will decrease. Why that particular decrease in illumination is there? So that is actually due to the aging of lamps. Aging of lamps means similarly being as living beings, human beings, as we do have a lifetime, similarly every product has also some particular lifetime, or we say it as the age or the lifetime of the product. Similarly, the lights also, due to this aging of those lamps, what will happen is around that particular lamp, the dust gets accumulated. So when the dust gets accumulated, where the dust gets accumulated on the reflecting and the transmitting surfaces. So on the ceiling and walls, so wherever on the fixtures, clear? So when the dust gets accumulated, so ultimately what will happen is we have to, that means in and around the illumination area, if it is not perfectly clean, then comes the maintenance factor into picture. So what is maintenance factor? So it is, the maintenance factor is defined as ratio of ultimate maintained meter candles on the working plane to initial meter candle. That means it is measured, that is, it is, as it is a ratio, it is unitless. Okay, so it is the ratio of maintained meter candles. That means how much area you are maintaining it. Clear? Of the ultimate maintained meter candles on the working plane and on the working plane or the working surface to initially what is the meter candle. Okay, that so what is actually candles, you already as we have studied, candles is what is the unit of, what is the unit of candela, is the unit of actually photometric, or you can say the SI unit of candela, that is intensity, luminous intensity we are talking about. So when we talk about these candles, intensity of light, initially what is the light? Okay, so presently what is the light in candelas, that intensity? Okay, that intensity you have to divide by the initial intensity when it was new. So that ratio is called as maintenance factor. So its value is more, the maintenance factor value will be more if the lamp fittings are cleaned regularly. If you're cleaning the in and around the lamps very regularly, then ultimately what will happen is the maintenance factor will be more, say 0.8. And if there is more, much dust across, then ultimately the maintenance factor will be very coming around 0.6. Okay, so this is maintenance factor. Then comes here a depreciation factor. Now, depreciation factor is the inverse of maintenance factor. Okay, the inverse of maintenance factor means ultimately, what was the definition for this particular maintenance factor? Ratio of ultimate maintained meter candle on the working plane to initial meter candle. So this will be reverse. So in case of depreciation factor, it is defined as the ratio of initial meter candle to ultimate maintained meter candle on the working plane. Now here, in this case, the value of depreciation factor will be more than unity. And here, in case of maintenance factor, here the value will be always in between 0 to 1, less than 1. But here, depreciation factor, the always, as it is the inverse of maintenance factor, the value will of the depreciation factor will be more than unity. Okay. So this is all about the second method, which is Lewman method or light flux method, which is very, very important. So the formula here is lumens received on working plane is number of lamps into wattage of each lamp into efficiency of each lamp in terms of lumens per watt into coefficient of utilization. This depreciation factor, which is there in the denominator, will come into picture when the surroundings are not clean. So how to calculate depreciation factor? You know the formula. Clear? Just now we have read. So next method is called as your point to point or inverse square law method. So what is point to point or inverse square law method? Now here, this particular method is applicable where the illumination at a particular point is due to one or more sources of light, okay, is required. Now that means if the source of light is more than one, then we are using this point to point or inverse square law method. Clear? So here it is the candle powers of that particular light source is in a particular direction, that is under consideration, it is being known. That means if a polar curve of lamp and its reflector is giving candle powers of the lamp in different directions, then the illumination at any point within the range of the lamp, you can easily calculate it. So here we have to calculate the illumination at any point. Clear? So by which law? Inverse square law we are going to find out. Now, what he is saying is, if the sources of light are more than one, so they are going to use this particular method in order to find out this particular illumination. So illumination at any point, you can calculate by the light source is more than one. For example, if more than two or more light sources lamps are illuminating in the same working area, so the previous one, that is lumen, which you have talked about, that is Lewman method or this light flux method, we are talking about only one light source here. Okay, lumen and light, lumen or light flux method. But in case of this particular point to point or inverse square law method, when two or more than two lamps are illuminating in the same working plane, then how to calculate the illumination? The illumination due to each of that particular lamp, you can calculate and you can add at the end. So this method is, we are not using much because it is a little bit complicated and some complicated applications and cumbersome applications, calculations are also there. So it is only employed in only those kind of problems where there is a flood lighting, where there is a flood light and yard lighting is there. Okay. So in those cases only you are using this point to point or inverse square law method. So this is all about the three methods which we have studied, that is watt per square meter method. Clear? So watts per square meter method, again repeating, it's a very rule of thumb method. So here, how much watts is required per meter square area, per meter square, how much watts of power, how much watt bulb or how much watt of lighting is required in order to illuminate that particular area of that area, how much illumination is required. So that assumption is totally on average figure of overall efficiency of the system. And second method is lumen or light flux method. For that we have a formula which is very, very important. And here we have already studied that how to calculate how much lumens here is received on the working plane. If there are more than one lamp, then we are considering this point-to-point or inverse square law method. So in the next class, we will be doing some problems related to these methods. I hope you have understood this. Okay, and thank you.